Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today I will be teaching you guys how to create depth of field effect in Maya using V-Ray Next. So, what is depth of field? Depth of field is used to focus a part of a scene and defocus, blur the rest of the scene. There are two ways we can create a depth of field effect in Maya using V-Ray. Number 1. Render Z-depth path using render elements and then use it in a post-production application. Number 2. Use V-Ray camera built-in depth of field functionality to render physically accurate depth of field effect. In this video, I will teach you the second method, which is more physically accurate, and make a separate tutorial for Z-depth path. So without any further ado, let's get started. First, look at the scene setup. My camera is somewhere here. That's my first car, second car, and background. You can see there is a huge difference between all of these objects. As far as lighting is concerned, I have simply used dome light and HDRI with it to light it. Nothing special in this scene other than this. Now select V-Ray physical camera. You can convert any of Maya standard camera into V-Ray physical camera by going to attributes, V-Ray, and make sure physical camera is checked. Now you will get an extra V-Ray attributes rollout. And your standard camera will work as a V-Ray physical camera. Before we turn on depth of field, just take a render for comparison. Creating depth of field is a four-step process. Step 1. Check enable depth of field. Step 2. Specify the object you want to focus. To do this, you need to go to Display, Heads-up Display, check Object Details. I want to focus the red truck. So, I will select the red truck and look at the distance from camera. It is approximately 1000 right now. Now, select the camera again, check specify focus, and enter the focus distance 1000. Render and compare. I can't see any visible depth of field right now. Why? The reason for this is that the F number, also known as aperture, its value is large. Step 3. Change F number. Large F number produces large depth of field, which we can see here. The depth of field is so large that this orange car is not blurred. It is also in focus. So we need to decrease the F number value, because a smaller F number produces small depth of field, which is actually what we want here. So decrease the F number from 8 to 2.4. Select a region and start interactive rendering. When you decrease F number, the light increases. Step 4. Change shutter speed or ISO. There are two ways to correct the light. Increase shutter speed or decrease ISO. I normally increase my shutter speed. So I will increase my shutter speed to, let's say, 1500. It is still bright, so increase it to 2300. And now I am happy with my values. Now the light is correct. So stop interactive rendering and do a full render. You can see the front red car is in focus while the back orange car is blurred. I will just quickly compare it with my previous image. You can see this orange car is now blurred. If you want this orange car to be more blurred than this, then you have to again decrease your F number and increase your shutter speed. I will quickly do interactive rendering again because I know whenever I will decrease my F number, my light will bright. To correct the brightness, I will increase my shutter speed to, let's say, 8000. I will go to something around 9000. Now I am happy with my light intensity. Stop interactive rendering, turn off render region and render again. You can clearly see that the orange car is more blurred right now. And even the background. So this was F number 2.4, F number 1.2. When I decrease my F number, the backgrounds get more blurry. Now, I want to focus on the orange car and defocus the rest of the scene. To do this, I have to simply select my orange car, see its distance from camera, it's 37-36 right now. And in my focus distance, I will enter this value. Now, render and compare. Wow, the orange car is in focus right now and the other parts of the scene are defocused or blurred. So guys, creating depth of field is extremely easy. It's just a 4-step process. First, enable depth of field. Second, specify focus. Third, change your F number. Fourth, change your shutter speed. That's all for this tutorial. If you like this video, give it a like. If you love this video, subscribe to my channel, share my videos, keep creating guys. Bye bye.